Hello, everyone. How are you? Korean Buddhism Lecture 10th. It's Identity, Culture, and History by Korea Dharma Master, Venerable Wonung Bogum, Dr. Lee Chira. Korean Buddhism. Missionary work is the way to survive. However, the answer is simple. The Sangha is the first to return to its original place. We must return to temple and slow ourselves practicing and preaching. It is about restoring the monastic community society together. I think we need to open up a space for lay people to participate to some extent. I believe that lay people must have an area and space where they can work in order to revive our fading Buddhism together with the Sangha. Now, in order to re-establish Korean Buddhism, we must recognize that the power of Sangha alone is insufficient. I think it would be really difficult to give them some kind of role and not move forward with Buddhism together. As the number of Sangha is decreasing, I think the Sangha must first recognize that it is difficult for the Sangha to be independent and ignore lay people. Recently, in Korean Buddhism, there has been a conflict between the monastic order and the laity. And I don't think that's really a good thing. Now we need to have an honest discussion about reconciliation and common tasks we must pursue together. We need to make a small concession to each other and look at the bigger picture. But I think that for now, members of the monastic order who have become target of corruption need the virtue of quietly secluding themselves. If the power of Buddhism is weakened by divisions like this, what can be the only result other than a weakening of a Buddhism community? If we say that our Buddhism has reached turning point, most people in Buddhist community are reluctant to believe it. When you look outside from inside the room, you can see clearly and sometimes even feel a sense of freshness. But on the other hand, it is not easy to see inside from the outside. If you don't open the door, you can look inside. Moreover, looking inside doesn't give any feeling because you are always looking at it. It is difficult to get a sense of whether it is in good condition or it is in disarray. The analogy is a bit weak, but if we look at our current Korean Buddhism calmly, the answer is simple. There are concerns that something is going wrong somewhere, but most Buddhists don't seem to have that feeling. Let's look back at Korean Buddhism from 20 or 30 years ago. It is commonly said that the number of monks passing by Jogesa Temple exceeds 500 on average every day. You could always see a monk, and it wasn't that difficult to see a monk wearing a monk's robe anywhere in Korea. Let's imagine what it will be like 10 or 20 years from now. Why do we have doubt about whether we will be able to see monks anywhere in Korea, even at that point? That means the future is unclear and uncertain. After Buddha became a saint, the disciples with whom he first devoted himself to practice came to mind. You might have a thought, how can I persuade other people without first doing it? Although it is difficult to understand the Buddha's true feelings, at least in order to spread the Dharma, he cannot prove his existence either first convincing the first five disciples. So he went straight from Bodhgaya to Deer Park to meet them. The Buddha went to the Deer Garden Park via the Ganges River and first met the five monks. As soon as they saw the Buddha, they immediately recognized him as an enlightened man and knelt down to be his disciples. Buddha gave his first sermon to these first five monks. What I want to emphasize here is the fact that Buddhist history began when the Buddha began preaching. Practice is important, but propagating the teachings is also very important. Once you have achieved the Tao, perfect your character, you must share your enlightenment. There cannot be a single Taoist. It would be against the spirit of Buddhism to go into seclusion as a solitary Taoist. It's just Buddhism, like Taoism. Therefore, Buddhist countries such as Ceylon and Tibet attach great importance to the propagation of the teachings. No matter how great a religion, religious doctrine system it has, if it does not gather believers through evangelism, it will be nothing more than a straw man religion. Therefore, the world's religions are trying to their best to spread their religious doctrines and ideals. It cannot help but be said that the enlightenment of the religious leaders also depends on the religious benefit obtained through the propagation of the religious doctrine. Even if the religious leaders' enlightenment is spurious, the doctrinal system is well established, and the philosophy is excellent. If this is not widely known as disseminated, religious community will not be formed. We learn these lessons from other religions, but if we only learn and know, but do not put into practice, the future of our religion becomes bright as if we are seeing fire. Previously, I mentioned the phenomenon of Korean Buddhism 20 or 30 years ago. At the time, it was thought that Korean Buddhism would prosper. Everyone worked hard to build temple building. The fact that effort was put into improving the exterior of the temple, such as building too many buildings and decorating only the pavilion with Danchong. Danchong means red and blue. You know, you paint in the was not related to future of Buddhism. This is because it was already believed that Buddhism would reach its heyday. I reached the point where I had to confess that I was faced with a situation where I had to honestly admit that I lacked the ability to analyze future of Buddhism. Let's predict the next 10 or 20 years. How will Korean Buddhism progress? It is bound to be a very pessimistic prediction. But most people in Buddhist community easily make Taoist-like thought and remarks that Buddhism will never disappear. And I think this is a truly dangerous view. If you look at Korean Buddhism from 20 years ago, you can clearly see the next 20 years. But if you don't see it and think that our Buddhism will always run well, I think you are lacking in vision. Looking at the world of Buddhism as a glance, everyone would not believe it if we said that future of Korean Buddhism is the most uncertain. In fact, recognize that Korean Buddhism is the Buddhism that has the most favorable objective condition, requires considerable prior knowledge, and requires seeing a lot of Buddhism from other countries. It is also not easy to see Buddhism from outside the room. Those who have only seen our Buddhism are optimistic about the future of Korean Buddhism. But I never see it that way. He's a person who believes that it cannot be done without radical transformation of the current preaching of Buddhist doctrine. Currently, Korean Buddhism is practicing well to a certain degree. Each temple is well equipped, and the temples are sufficiently equipped. However, if there are no monks in sight and there is no effort to propagate Buddhism, I think this is a very disturbing sign. But some people may not be concerning about this concern at all. It is questionable whether these people are wearing colored glasses that do not allow them to properly see the reality of Korean Buddhism. Let's take a look around. It feels as if Buddhism is surrounded by influence and must fear of other religions. The question is, if this situation continues, will Buddhism remain impact? Therefore, warfare and missionary work are more important than practice. If the monastic order cannot do something, drastic change in thinking is needed, leaving it to the layperson. So, I gave 5 lectures about the Korean Buddhism. I mean, modern day problem of Korean Buddhism. So, first of all, I analyzed. And finally, I suggest that we must preach, propagate Buddhism. Otherwise, Buddhism cannot survive. That's why I suggest that we should propagate. Propagation is much important than practice, I mean. So, generally speaking, Korea now we practice meditation, but because, you know, now believers is getting less, young generation doesn't want to join the Sangha, so we need to propagate, we need to spread Buddhism. That's why I gave a lecture on this theme. Thank you very much for your listening. Thank you.